Hello everyone, welcome to Codoid's YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to explain how to set up Cucumber event listener in your project. So before jumping into that, so I'll explain why we need a Cucumber event listener. Let's say if you have a separate reporting system, and then if you have built that, in that case you can use event listener to ingest all the scenario status into your reporting system. So we at Codoid have a separate reporting system, and then to detect the anomalies. So if any scripts if any script is failing often, and then if it is failing at one particular day or one particular time, and then if you are not able to detect that, so we can use anomaly detector to see which scripts are failing often. So for that purpose, we use event listener to ingest all the scenario status into our reporting system. So now you know why we need event listener. If you have already if you have already used extend report or Allure report, even a report portal, all these libraries are using event listener to ingest a scenario status. So now I'll show you how to set up event listener in JVM Cucumber project. So let's get into that. So now already I have a project, so which has a simple feature file, and then I have a step def for that. So step def, all these step def methods have only sysout. So I have not done any Selenium related implementation. So because this topic is only for Cucumber listener, so I'm directly going to create a listener. So the objective is I'm going to create listener, and then inside the listener class I'm going to create a after scenario method, and I'm going to print status of each scenario. So I have a util package here. So inside util package, I'm creating one more Java class. I'm naming it as my listener. And then implement the event listener interface. So you have to select Cucumber plugin event listener. So now you have your event listener. So you have to write what you are going to do inside after scenario. So for that you have to write a separate method. The class to listen after scenario, here scenario is considered as test case. So once test case is finished, this method needs to be called. So that's why I'm calling test case finished event. And then I'm going to print the status of my scenario. So this method will be called whenever any scenario is execution is completed. So event dot get result. That's it. So here in this method block, it will print the status of the scenario. So now the last step is you need to attach this method to your event listener. So to do that, call a method register handler for, and then again type test case finished dot class, come on. So I'm using this because the after scenario is available within this class. So your event listener is ready now. So now you need to integrate this into your runner class. use cucumber options. And so this is a plugin for you. That is a customized plugin. This is how you do it for extend report also. So now I have to give the class name. So first I have to start with the package name. It is under utils and give the listener name. That's it. Now go ahead and run the runner class. See, this is a sort print, so it is printing the status of your scenario once it is executed. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. So subscribe our channel, and then more videos will be uploaded in coming days. Yeah, thank you very much.